And speaking of young people, this week an army of teenagers has invaded the Granite State. They're armed with paintbrushes, hammers, and ladders, as well as the common goal of helping strangers.
Never mind whistling while you work.
A big, big yard where we can play football touchdown. A big, big house.
While other kids their age are spending the summer playing video games or hanging out at the mall, these high schoolers from around the country are in New Hampshire, helping people they've never met. It's called the Group Work Camp. Not that any of them really consider it work.
It's actually rewarding, to tell you the truth. It's just kind of giving back to communities that need it.
I'm learning along with some of the people. Some of the older guys in my crew are telling me how to do some things. It's a lot of fun.
They help folks in the community who are low income or disability, who either can't afford or don't have the means just physically to do the work.
This week, 400 kids are busy painting, roofing, or repairing nearly 60 homes in New Hampshire free of charge. And homeowner George Corrales couldn't be more grateful.
They're doing a great job, and they're nice kids. They're beautiful kids.
And the kids, or more likely their parents, actually pay for them to come to these camps. And sponsorships by local churches and community groups help out as well. The teamwork aspect can't be overlooked either. These kids start as strangers and bond through a common goal of helping others.
You just make a lot of new friends, and it's kind of good to have connections everywhere, so it's really great.
And through this camp, a work ethic is born as well.
Absolutely. We tell them now you go home, you can't tell your parents you can't help. You know how to do some things.
The Group Work Camp is a national organization with 24,000 campers. In fact, some of them are on the Gulf Coast of the United States this year, helping rebuild hurricane-ravaged neighborhoods one home at a time. But this summer, the Group Work Camp in New Hampshire is actually focusing its efforts in the area of Sutton and Bradford. So here's the question. What do you do? Where do you put 400 teenagers? Well, they camp out on the floor of the Kearsarge Middle School, and the principal says the decision to help out was an easy one.
So it's really an awesome experience. I've seen kids in many camps, and camps are always fun. But when you're doing something to give back to the community, it's just, like you said, a no-brainer.
Next summer, the kids will be back in New Hampshire doing the same work for people, but this time in the towns of Franklin and in Hudson.